Today I have a service call on this heat pump unit. Here is my thermostat on the heat pump, and then I'm just gonna look at here's the unit, see what it says. Unit is off, I think so. Nothing is happening. Nothing is happening here. Okay, system heat backup, system mode heat. Okay, so okay, so let's see what's happening. Okay, my fan kick in. So let's see what's happening here. Still did not got my compressor kick in. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna have to open the chassis, go inside the chassis. I'm gonna have to turn off my water inlet and the water outlet, turn both off and pull out this chassis and measure it, measure my, see if I have 24 volt in my contactor, and then also on my water inlet, because once the water inlet closes, it should send power to the contactor. So I'm going to have to do that. Okay, so I finally pull out the unit, and here, this unit, I want to see what I have on my CC to ground. So my CC to ground, I have 24 foot coming in. You can see my 24 foot on my voltmeter here, and then measuring my W, and I have 24 volts. So what should be powering this compressor is the compressor terminal here. It's a contactor here. So this one. So I don't have 24 volts on this compressor terminal. And then on the other side, either way, I don't get 24 volts. So what is sending power to this contactor terminal is this actuator. This is water, kind of like an actuator or water regulating. So I don't have that. So here is what I should be doing is, these are the wire to the actuator. This is the wire to the actuator. So I'm just gonna take this one out. This is the connection to the actuator. Take that out. Here it's 24 volts, so that you still have to be careful while doing the job. So I just want to give it a push and start. I'm only temporary, just gonna do it, not for a long. So here I'm gonna just jump right together and see. Wow, so my compressor kicking. So now I knew my compressor kick in. I'm gonna give it a shot again so you see it. Yeah, you see my compressor kicking. So compressor kicking, that tell you my actuator is the problem here. So I'm gonna have to go and get a new actuator to this unit. So we'll come back. Wow, this beautiful neighborhood here in Brampton. Beautiful neighborhood, a nice nice property. So let's get started, let's get going. Okay, so as earlier stated, here is the actuator. This is the actuator that is bad. So the function of this, once power came in here from this 6C, it goes to the actuator here. And once the actuator closes, it will send the power to the compressor contactor.
the compressor contactor will send power to the compressor, and then the compressor will close. And then when the contactor closes, power comes to the compressor. The compressor will energize, and then the system will start operation. But right now, the compressor is not working as a result of this actuator that is at fault. So I'm going to have to change the actuator. So here is the new actuator here. This is the actuator here, and this is how it's going to be installed. So once power comes in, you see the actuator moving. It's going to move to open. Right now it's on the closed position. So after installation, connecting on the wire, we will take it from there. Okay, so here is the details wiring diagram of the unit. So if you want to take a look, hopefully whichever way. So to look at the information on the unit, is also on the other side. So here is the information of the unit, and it's made by Willen Company. Okay, so I'm going to just push in back the unit, push everything back in, and then we'll turn on the unit. We'll see what's going on. Okay, so the unit is pushed back in. You can see it's on standby, so we're going to look. Again, this control is going to take a while to initiate. And after initiation, you're looking at almost about 5 sometimes to 10 minutes the way it was set up. So I'm gonna try to call for more heat. Please subscribe to this channel, like it and share it. Again, this is Brampton, Ontario, and this is a condo heat pump. Please subscribe. We drop more of this video, you'll be able to see it right away. Please subscribe. Thank you. I'm gonna try to show you how this actuator really functions. Right now you can see how the actuator is located, but as soon as the thermostat calls for heat or cooling, the actuator is gonna open and send power to the contactor, to the compressor, and then the compressor will just kick in. So whether heating or cooling, you're gonna see. I'm gonna wait and see how. I'm gonna try to show it to you as soon as there's a 24 volt coming in. So let's wait. Okay, so thermostat kicking. Let's see what action. Let's watch the actuator now. Let's watch the actuator. My fan is on now. See, the actuator is moving. So 24 volt came in here, you see the compressor kicking right away. Okay, so I'm not going to leave this place open like this. I have to close it so that the fan could just pick up all the heat here. Then the fan could be able to take it to the building. So I'm going to have to close it. So now it's closed. So I think this unit is okay now. Please subscribe to this channel, subscribe, and then share it. And anyone who have any comment, please put it at the comment below. We will reply. Thank you. So this is all we do on this HVAC mechanical system. This is Willen unit. This is all the information. Thank you.